So today I'm going to talk about uterus cancer. Actually, of all the cancer in the world that a woman can get, uterus cancer is the best you can ever get. Why? Because uterus cancer is the easiest to treat. It has very good life expectancy and it has a very high cure rate. So most people with uterus cancer can nicely and easily be treated. There are a lot of confusion between uterus cancer and cervical cancer. Whenever I tell a certain woman that with this condition, your risk of uterus cancer is very high, or I may say that your condition is actually a pre-cancer, and they will always tell me that, but doctor, I already took my vaccine already. They always think they took the vaccine is for uterus cancer, but actually it's not for uterus cancer. Vaccine is for cervical cancer. We know that cervical cancer is purely due to a viral infection we call HPV virus, but uterus cancer is not due to infection and it can be hereditary. Uterus cancer come about when there is an imbalance. Women has two hormones, the estrogen and progesterone, so there are two hormones. And these two hormones actually work opposite. So if you have a lot of progesterone, then your estrogen will be suppressed, and you have a lot of estrogen, your progesterone will be suppressed. And in uterus cancer, we always say that it's due to the imbalance. That means there's too much estrogen or there's too little progesterone. Because if you have too little progesterone, then you cannot suppress the estrogen. Because when you have progesterone, you will suppress the estrogen and the effects of estrogen. Estrogen level, if high, few things. One is we talk about your weight. Because we know that our fats produce estrogen. So if you're overweight or you are obese, then very likely you have a very high level of estrogen. They are the women with irregular menses. Irregular menses, if your menses is irregular, there must be imbalance. Imbalance between the estrogen and progesterone. So if your hormones are imbalanced, your period is irregular, your risk of uterus cancer is high. There are several types. One group are women that have always have irregular menses since they are teenager. And these women, if they don't take care properly, they can get even uterus cancer in their late 20s. My youngest uterus cancer in this group of women is only in her 20s, 27, 28 years old. Then the second group of women is they have regular menses all their life. They have regular menses all their life, but when you know towards nearing to menopause in your 40s, that is when you have all this menopausal problem, your period become irregular, right? And then that is when your chances of uterus cancer comes. So remember, when your period is irregular, your chance of uterus cancer is high, because it means there's an imbalance between estrogen and progesterone. Third group of women that is after menopause can still have high risk of uterus cancer. Uterus cancer can still come in your 60s, 70s, 80s. Who are they? Number one, those obese women, they are still at risk. Why? Because even though we say after menopause, all our hormones will come down, right? But if you are obese, then you will still be producing a lot of estrogen because you have estrogen from the fats. Fats can produce estrogen. So even after your menopause, when you menopause, your ovaries may not produce the estrogen anymore, but your fats will continue to produce estrogen. So another group of women that we always talk about, the diabetic women, or we like to call it the PCOS women. Some people call PCOS, some people call PCOS, and in other words, we call polycystic ovarian syndrome. Number one, they tend to be fat or obese. Number two, their period is always irregular, so the imbalance between estrogen and progesterone is also always there. And they usually have this problem from very young. They bring all the way until they are old. So even though after they have menopause, because through the years and years and years exposing yourself to high levels of estrogen, you are still at risk of uterus cancer even after your menopause, even when you are in your 60s or 70s. Okay, so these are the group of women that are at risk of uterus cancer. So next, how do we know that you have uterus cancer or pre-cancer? So uterus also the same. It has a lot of pre-cancer stages before it causes cancer. And these pre-cancer stages, we call it endometrial hyperplasia. So endometrial hyperplasia, it is a pre-cancer for uterus cancer. Early signs of uterus cancer, or in fact sign of uterus cancer, whether early or late, is abnormal menstrual bleeding. Number one, menstrual bleeding that doesn't know how to stop. You see, normally your menstrual bleeding is 5 days, 7 days, but this one already more than 10 days. So menstrual bleeding that don't know how to stop, number one. Number two, menstrual bleeding that is so heavy, so much. You never had it so much before. Now you have it so much. Number three, you have menstrual bleeding not when you're supposed to be having menses. That means usually we call it intermenstrual bleeding. That means you have one menses here, you have another menses here, then in between you have a little bit bleeding. And usually it's not a lot. Number four is what? You already menopause. 1 year, 2 years, 5 years, 10 years, no menses. Suddenly, menses come back. There's postmenopausal bleeding. Basically, if you see your gynae early, when you have all these signs, you go and see gynae, most of the time, it is still pre-cancer. Pre-cancer means endometrial hyperplasia. So if it's still endometrial hyperplasia, simple, all you need is to follow your gynae's instruction, get it treated. Okay, get it treated. And I hope I have shared enough all this while. I hope I can keep doing it. So I really, really need suggestions from you all. Okay, bye bye.